right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is John Arbuthnot. He's the CEO of Delta 9 Cannabis. So John, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Steve, thank you for having me.
So lots of stuff to talk about with you. First off, your Q2 2021 financials will be coming out. So you're offering a little bit of guidance to the market and some good guidance because the numbers look pretty strong so far.
Yeah, guidance out to the market a little early on this quarter, Steve. So we're guiding the market to 15.5 to 17.25 million in top line revenue for the second quarter this year. That's up from 13.2 million in the first quarter this year and from 13 million for the same period last year. So back into growth mode, you know, wanting to get that guidance out to there to the market that, you know, expect positive top line momentum into the second quarter here. Final results will come out August 16th, pre-market open for investors to get that full look and insight into those Q2 results.
John, where's the increase coming from? Is it in retail?
You know, really across all three business segments, Steve. So we're seeing, you know, strong growth in retail, up off of the first quarter where we saw a little bit of a seasonal decline, as did much of the Canadian cannabis industry in January, February. But strong growth in same stores into that second quarter, as well as some new store openings that came in March, April, starting to contribute some positive revenue growth in retail. Wholesale sales, likewise, strong in the second quarter, and now starting to see a real uptick in our B2B business. So all three business segments now firing on all cylinders.
John, I'm wondering what your strategy is for continuing that growth. You mentioned that you've had some, you know, obviously all three sectors are doing well. So what do you do now to try and continue that momentum over the next year and beyond?
So, you know, I'll say retail continues to be, I think, the main focus for expansion. We see, I think, huge strategic benefit in controlling distribution, controlling that path right through to the end consumer. Focus of this expansion will be twofold. We are continuing to build out stores. We call that our organic growth strategy, building out these stores and opening them. But now M&A, I think industry on the retail side, ripe for consolidation across markets like Alberta, like Saskatchewan, even into Manitoba here now. So, you know, I think that dual strategy in terms of retail expansion on the wholesale side of our business, just that focus on high quality, high potency flower, building that brand awareness with the end consumer. We're automating our pre-roll line currently. That'll continue to add efficiencies. We've been big on cost efficiencies in our wholesale business to drive down costs and be able to sustain margin compression in a competitive market environment. And new derivative and 2.0 products that we will be looking to launch under our Delta 9 brand as well. And on the B2B side of the business, the US expansion. So now shifting the sales efforts south of the border, looking to see exposure to some of the upside that we think is coming in the US market prior to federal legalization down there. And again, that shift in US strategy, I think, already underway for the B2B segment.
So does that mean you want to have more access to people as far as, you know, trading the stock is concerned in the US as well? Have you looked at the options of that, NASDAQ and things like that?
Yeah, certainly. So companies' shares are currently listed on the OTCQX. Yeah. Symbol there is DLTNF. But certainly, I mean, to your point, a senior exchange listing, a New York and NASDAQ listing, something the company is certainly considering. Right now, I think something that needs to play a part of our strategy, you know, as we look forward to continuing to expand our business operations, we also need to expand that capital markets profile. And, you know, I think investors only need look, you know, to the latest, you know, call it bull run in the cannabis sector in kind of November to February this year. It was those stocks that are listed on senior U.S. exchanges, which have traditionally seen the best liquidity. And which saw the most significant momentum into that market trend. So certainly something the company will be considering in the future.
So obviously, depending on the way the pandemic goes, and obviously we've seen it's been going well the last little while, which is positive news. Are you planning on potentially attending conferences this fall? Is that something you're looking at?
Yes, thank goodness things are moving in the right direction. to start to get some travel back in our universe. A few upcoming conferences that are virtual, the Money Show on July 13th this year, the SNN conference August 18th. Then into September, October, we actually do start to see some international travel opportunities and conferences. We will be attending the Benzinga Cannabis Conference in New York, October 13th, 14th. We will be attending MJ BizCon in Las Vegas the following week. So now starting to get back into some of the more routine travel opportunities. I think great opportunity as well to throw investor eyes on the stock and you know, as you pointed to, expand that investor base into the United States.
Yeah. John, one last thing I want to ask you about, and that is you put together a really interesting program around the vaccination program in Manitoba that's been very successful. You've been getting a lot of praise for this. So tell me a little bit about Joints for Jabs.
Yes, Joints for Jabs, essentially a vaccine rewards program for our retail customers, allowing them to come into store, demonstrate that they are fully vaccinated, be entered into a rewards program to receive a few grand prizes, actually a year's supply of cannabis, giving away a few thousand cannabis joints or pre-rolls as a part of that program. And of course, Delta 9 branded apparel and swag for customers. Really saw this as our opportunity to, you know, do the right thing as a part of the business community. You know, start to tell the message, you know, repeat the messaging that the province, that the country has been putting out there in the public sphere, that very important to get vaccinated. That is what is ultimately going to allow for our country to open things back up.
Absolutely. So important. Get your vaccine. John, congratulations on the success. And we look forward to probably seeing you on the road sometime in the fall. So great to see you again. Thanks very much.
Steve, thank you for having me.
All right. There's John Arbuthnot, the CEO of Delta 9 Cannabis.